Hello, folks. Rever here with another episode of Gifts of the Caucasus. I am just a few minutes after the last episode ended. I am here filling up a silage bin. It's 1 o'clock. I forget what kind of math I did to figure out 6 o'clock tonight that bunker number 4 would be ready, but we're already unloading it. And the sunflower harvester looks like he needs to be taken care of. Once I dump this load, I'll hop back over there. Hopefully it won't be too late. It may well be too late by the time I dump this. Just back this up and come on, buddy. Once again, if I get him down to 50%, he'll definitely make it back the other way, which I think I'll be able to do. Caught up to them in plenty of time, I think. So the other thing I'm doing, if you see the little course play symbol on the other side of this field down on the map, is we are seeding rye as we're taking this off. So one end of the field's being planted, the other one, get ready to do the silage operation on this field after, not silage, slurry operation. Get the field fertilized. I still haven't heard from the real estate agent, but you can see we got almost $1 million, which is nice to see because I could just about pay off all my debt right now if I chose to, and I think that's, you know, something I could have done before, but certainly a sign of when I'm flirting with paying off the debt. Now we're going to buy that field, which will wipe that out, but hopefully we'll buy the field anyway. Can't imagine he's going to come back with more than $900,000. And I will try to pay off as much loan as I can tonight, just because we borrowed that extra money. I'd like to get it back down again. All right, so let's go back to this guy. Keep him busy filling this thing up. And then what I thought we could do is after we fill this one, go and fill up that silage bunker that's by the cattle, up by the main farm there. See, I have my T8, the 400 horsepower one. I'm going to bring him in here to compact that. Plus, if I'm right, my slurry, the slurry spreader is right there, so when he gets done compacting, I'll run him over to the field and start slurrying. Hopefully not too long after that, the guy's done with the seeding, and then I can have him bring up loads of slurry up to that field. I shouldn't need too much extra. It would be one good thing about field. One of the reasons for wanting 17 is that I could start using up some of the slurry on that big huge field there, which I could probably actually do as soon as I buy it, so it's not like we have to wait for the planting to be done. We might even maybe even slurry it first and then plant. Kind of running low on tractors in some ways, but I'm not sure how much more craziness I would want. At some point here, the fields will go ripe. And I was thinking, you know, 13's awful close. I'll probably get 300,000 or something like that in grass off of that field. So I may, just because by the time I fill up that bunker, I'll have a good amount of silage. And if things are typical, I will need about as much silage and straw as I'll need you know, equal amounts of each, except for the straw. I think it's, if I'm right, the grass and the silage are the most, and then followed by a bit of straw, like maybe half as much as the other two. But we'll probably take all the straw off of that rye. So that'll be a, you know, kind of a hit to our chaffing operation and our silage operation, but hopefully it'll pay off. We'll be prepared to buy the animals with plenty of feed, and by the time that silage is done, I would hope to have the money to buy the TMR mixer. And how are we looking here? Yep, that guy's on his... All right, hurry up, buddy. We're almost done with this, which is nice. So yeah, we'll have, what, let's guess 50,000 sunflowers, which would be good if we get a quick delivery kind of thing. And then we have field 16 that's planted in sunflowers, so that'll get us the, nice buffer, at least for now. Like I said in the last video, we'll see how much we end up with. We may just replant immediately in sunflowers on field 16, but we'll take a look at what's in demand. How are we doing? And we crossed another hour, but grass still hasn't grown, so kind of good. I'd like to get this field settled before I worry about cutting grass and all that stuff. Not that we're in that much of a hurry for anything, but sort of want to keep that silage thing as full as I can. That means cutting the grass as soon as, not missing a cycle. It takes a little while to cut that grass, a couple hours in real life time at least. Alright, this guy's in good shape. We'll take him up the other... Well, no, you know what? We're not even going to do that. We'll just leave him there. Oh, we'll try to get to the right tractor. Let's pop on F1 here and see how... I bet you we're not even halfway yet. This is what, like, probably my fourth load. I hadn't done too much before I got on the mat. Yep, 48%. So we're halfway done, which is... Each one of these trips gets me about 12%. I want to pull a little extra down this end. Speed up a little. I'm not sure how much it matters. It seems to even itself out pretty good. We're up to 60%. So while this guy is filling again, I'll run that other tractor back up to the other end of his field. Busy, busy, busy. Probably don't even need to go to the other end. That's good. We're well ahead of that cedar. It is nice when you don't have to... I'll tell you what, with all the stuff going on, not having to cultivate sure makes a difference. Like, so one of these... I forget exactly when. I think it was when we were doing field 10, 11, 12, and the grass was being chaffed, and just the whole 9 yards was the first time I actually, a growth cycle happened before I could catch up with it, which is a sign that I need to consider bigger equipment and maybe a little more course play, but it was just that one time. So what's this, four more loads after this? the last one being 12,000. Come on. Lag spike in the middle. Yeah, it gets... If you don't hit it straight, it really gets kind of wonky as this pile gets tall, and it's sort of hard to hit it straight when you're coming around that turn. So we should be up to 72%. And rye harvest, and he should have turned the corner by now. So let's hop back to him. Yep. And he's just about done. So I'll probably just... He's going to want to turn. This is one of those cases where he, for whatever reason, he harvests everything, but then he thinks he's got to go down the other end of the field. So we'll just chase him off the end and stop him. Yep, 50,000 was my guess, extra. So we'll end up with a little more than that. I don't think we'll get to 60. I doubt we'll get to 55. All right, let me pull him all the way forward. This guy. Might as well stop him. I think I can handle the rest, no problem. And we don't really need this course, though, I think. This course does well enough. I may end up just saving it. F19. Harvest. I want to call it corn. For now, that'll mean something to me. So let's get the rest of this little bit out of here, and we'll get these guys off the field, because we don't need that running. All right, so let's start folding things up. Leave him here, he's going to get in the way of the slurry guy, but that's okay. I want to get that bin filled up first. I'll take this guy down past the cedar so he doesn't get in the cedar guy's way. That should be good. We'll leave him glide to a stop. So get this guy filled up first. Then I can start that tractor compacting. That may not work out. Nope. Said you want to kind of hit it straighter than I just did there. I probably should turn. He'll pull him right up, but he just doesn't do a great job when he starts out at an angle like that. Yep, two more trips. I guess I can get, this guy's not in the trees, but there we go. Might as well pull him in and, look, I gotta wait. I don't really want to deal with that wait right now. Forgot it was down here. Let's come here to grass operations, and this is silo one. He'll be all ready to go. This is the wrong one. Can we see how much is in there? Maybe when we turn. Kind of curious to see how much I have left in this pile. 700,000, so we're getting down there. Said I think we'll run out of, by the time we fill up that bunker by the farm. I shouldn't do that. Let's go back up. Let's do a little loop-de-loop. That's better. Still kind of wonky. Yep, the next load will just be 12,000. Which doesn't hurt him getting up and down here. If you can tell, I have done this more than once. Whoa, sorry, buddy. Let's see, can we... That worked out better than it could have. This last little bit, top him off, and then we'll see how much. I don't even know how much that bunker up there holds, but I'm sure it's more than 61,000. A little disappointed I can't suck that stuff back out of it. Usually you can. All right, that's enough of that. Did I just run down that sign? Yeah, see what I mean? Like, even though I went off at a goofy angle, just because he had less in there, he did fine. And I'm not going to bother driving up over him again. We'll get him back filling up. Take him up to that bunker when he is full and check out that situation. There we go. Alright, so now let's jump into this guy. Get him up on the hill. Oops. All right, so he's now compacting. Let's go back to him. Yeah, so we'll get prepared to buy some more animals. We'll get the feeder pigs going. Maybe even at the end of this episode, I'm not sure what else might come up. can see all the way over there to that bunker. Alright, there we go. Hopefully we don't end up in the river. Turn this on, see how much. This doesn't look like a big bunker, but 15% is 52,000. Oops, what happened? Not in there enough. Yeah, so this guy shouldn't take too long to fill up. This might be a better bunker to kind of fill from one end to the next. We were at 5th, so one load is 15%. Not sure how much silage I really want to make, to be honest, either. I don't think I need that thing to necessarily be full. So I'll probably cut the video here, continue planting that field, and run a few more loads up there and come back when I don't know, probably right after I buy field 17, hopefully they don't charge me overly much for it. So I will see you guys in a second, or a few hours on my time. Guys, I'm out here cutting field 13, so I decided to definitely go with the more grass. And this guy's windrowing. I'm going to get run over. Let's hop into him, actually, because I think I may just stop him right here for a minute. That, so he starts out nicely. And then this guy. So this is the number one. This is the Deutzfar. This is some of the first field work I think he's done. And I got the crone going over there in the town field, getting chased by one of the agriliner trailer. This guy's the only tractor not being used. And this guy is collecting up the grass behind the windrower. So, the harvester's not busy, and the other tractor I usually use with the harvester. But, I don't know if you guys noticed the money yet, it's down. I don't know if you can see the exact amount of the money. But if I hit Shift-I, we now own field 17. So at some point with the little tree operation, I may push that tree operation far to the east. And then I might just sort of combine these two fields if there's any that I don't want to have grown as trees. They just are like begging to be made into one big field. So, on that note, this guy's selling silage. I'm going to start running low on silage, I know. Just because all of the fields we have. This one's rye, so this will give us a little bit of chaff. And we'll still keep doing the grass fields, but this one is sunflower. These are onions and carrots, and then this will be a little bit more rye, but then 17 I'm going to plant in canola. Wait for this loud machine. Now this, there we go, it'll be quiet this way. I'm sure you can hear me better. This is fermenting 6%. There's about 230 or 240, so I think it'll be plenty of silage to get started. So that took away a little bit more of the chaff. Speaking of chaff, yeah, it's about time to move over here. And like always, when I hop over here, he's on the other end of the field. So I'll chase him. And this is working out real well. Again, usually if I do the chasing, that's where course play seems to run into the most problems. Yeah, I have to free up a tractor, which should be happening soon. That it would be the tractor I'd pick, is that T8 with the 400 horsepower, the track one. That would be a good one to take out in that field with the harvester. Oh, the straw grass guy is full. Well, let's hop over there real quick just to stop him. Back here. So this guy does miss some still, but he misses no more than he ever did. And he, other than doing this little act right here where he slips for a second, none of the wheels are even turning. Pretty sure if we jump over to him. Yeah, I've got the four-wheel drive thing. Should be activated. Deactivate. I swear I didn't turn that off. Whatever. We'll see if that helps. It didn't in the past. So maybe it will, maybe it won't. And that's because he's trying to back up to the position. So, yeah, go over and cut some of that stuff you missed. Yeah, so sometimes he makes good turns, sometimes he doesn't. But all in all, I better get back in here. Oh yeah, by the way, you need to kind of get on top of this guy, because if you dilly-dally and miss too much time like this, it never... It isn't that much. Won't make it up on this little stretch of road. We won't empty this thing all the way, but it'll probably empty enough to get them done. Alright, the other thing I like about this trailer is it's not all unfolded if there's anything in it. So in other words, I feel like I could drive this on the road with a good amount of stuff in it if I have to leave. I don't know how the timing works out. While I'm chasing them. But it looks like in this case, it won't be too bad. Yeah, I'm just going to wait till I miss him. He's not going to fill up on that one road. There's fine. At this point, I'll probably just... I should probably do a course. I don't know. I'm not going to be doing grass that often. But you know what? Let me bring the first one over there, because then I can see better where the placeable heap is. It's like if you drive up to one of these placeable heaps and you don't want to back up, you can usually get close enough, but if all you see is that, you know, coin symbol looking thing, you know, you can't really gauge where the edge of the pile is as well. But if you put this 38,000 in there, it'll probably help. But this is kind of a long run left to make. He's only got 38,000. Guess we might as well stop by and feed some folks, huh? That was a good part of the reason for doing this. Buddies. Back for that. Can't even tell. The truck didn't go down at all. Cattle take a lot more though. And I think the mix station will be one of the next things that I buy. Let's check out how these guys are doing. Chickens are doing wonderful. Sheep are doing fine. This guy could use some more silage, but he's kind of got enough. No emergency. Alright. Should be reasonably good shape. For a little while. T8, wonderful. I can fire this other guy. Ooh. Looking up the dollars. Oh, no, I didn't. I don't know what the hell this is. All right, let's get into this guy real quick. Just get this guy kind of out of the way for now. Yeah, you don't get too much more out of the way than that. Hopefully he doesn't end up with a problem because he's too close. Alright, so see what I mean? Like, now that we have a better idea where that pile edge is, when we come around there, have a better idea where to go without getting too close to the pile, because then he runs up the pile and flips over. Right, let's do this. Let's get him off the field of duty. Get down past where this guy is. As soon as we get this grass going again, we'll get him started seeding. Where is this guy? You can begin again. You can get back to work too. And here's something that you can do that I don't see a lot of people doing, but I'm going to put current waypoint, and I might get even remotely confident that he's not going to run into something. Kind of release him. He will drive pretty much straight to that waypoint and restart where he left off. So the next time he gets filled up, we'll do a little course for him, just so we have it, so he runs. He's not going to hit anything. He'll take his time, but he'll get there. Let's jump into this guy. How's our chaff doing? He's only at 66%, so he's almost done. Yeah, there you go. Just turn. Let's get down to him. You're right quick. I'm not sure if you pay money when they're sitting there. That ends the issue. Alright, so we should have a good amount of grass before this is all over. And the next that I go, oh, by the way, I was talking about the chaff. I plan on taking some of that rye, getting a fair amount of straw built up. Rye windrow. And then that's canola I'm planting, it's not going to have any. We'll be back to just relying on the grass fields. OEB weight installed. Still got about 500 pounds on there, it looks like. Go get this guy full of canola. Nothing. Did switch the pipe. There we go, getting some rape seeds. So while that's going on, leaves a good amount around this field. It's not the best shaped field in the world for sure. So I'm going to pick up the rest of this and then go off and plant that field. Everything's getting almost full. So I got a lot of jumping around to do, and I forget even which tractor I was dealing with. And while we're here, we might as well put a little bit of gas in. Thing on a farm to hit gas pump. Really, we'll run into a lot of other stuff before you ever want to hit your gas pump. Right, so let's jump over to him. Stop driver. Right, plenty of fuel. Head down this way. Get the rape field going. We really don't have a ton of rye, but I'm growing some more of that right now. Really, canola, sort of the next lowest besides rye. Get some more potatoes going and sugar beets, probably after the carrots and onions. Like I said, whatever we end up with planting in 17 here, we will probably have plenty of it. Start here, you think? Guess it doesn't really make that much difference, does it? Question mark thing messes up the course plate thing. Right, get rid of that. Get rid of field 19. Working with 9 is fine, and we are in the northwest corner. We want him to go south. South is fine. We'll see how it goes. Headland 1. And we want the headland to be done after you do the up and downs. I'll show you what that looks like. Did something wrong? Northwest facing south. So where am I not in the northwest corner? Oh, back over there. I hate when I do that. One of the reasons I like starting in the longest, straightest corner. Not the only reason, mind you. Alright, that should be fine. Start him off at the first waypoint. Put him on the right mode. Alright, well, he's got his work cut out for him. And this guy we can record a course for real quick. A little bit further out. I don't think it matters too much. That course off. Start recording. get him all the way over to the other side here. I guess it would be better to loop around and drop off this. Rather than trying to make that turn right around the silo. Close enough you hit the trigger, but far enough away that the pile, even when it grows, doesn't mess you up too much. It will stop growing, you know, doesn't infinitely grow the more you put in it. We're going to ignore Dort's far over there, but that's good, he's done. See that water thing until I was past it. Could have very easily just run into it. Cross the tracks when I can avoid it. Really, as long as you don't ride down the same road, they don't usually hit. It's pretty. I mean, it does happen. Newhall T8 is slipping. Iron C slipping. All we need is a yellow light down there. We'll have the whole traffic signal going. I'm just going to ignore that and not let it irritate me that those things are going on and I'm not fixing them. I'm almost done recording this. I'm disappointed in Mr. T8 there. Oh, he got himself. Well, I don't know. Sometimes they're just wedging themselves in deeper. See, look, he's just wedging himself in deeper. My bet. Alright, stop. Save, so I don't forget. F13. Alright, F13, windrow to heat. Save it. Get rid of this. Close this, go over here, and I'll just move it right away. So then we want to load F13 windrow, and then add that one onto it. Can't use our current point anymore, because we'll close this course and reset it. That's a pretty good guess. I kind of forgot where the heck it was. What is going on there? That's not what I want. Whatever the hell that is. 13 windrow. Windrow to heat. Yeah, I hit the wrong one. Right, hopefully this works. Alright. Yeah, I guess that guy freed himself. Let's. I don't know if you get charged for them sitting here. I'm just going to sit him off to the side for now, because that's one of the reasons I used him. When he gets done chasing, so let's just check this guy. He's doing something. Yeah, I wonder what he got stuck on. This hill, maybe? Oh, yeah. Could have well been that hill. Go, man, you go. Just right on up and down that hill. I guess I should have done more than one headland. It's a shame this whole field's already cultivated. It wouldn't be good to take advantage of that. And he could have been up into that building, too. Nah, it doesn't look like he's going that far. Ah, whatever. He's back to work. So now it's time to move this operation, which I'll probably cut the video and, you know, see how long it is. It may have made an episode already. And if it has, I'll be back in the next episode. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. And I hope you have a good day. And take care of yourselves. And I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.